Welcome back to Mr. Ace Math. This lesson is on types of algebraic expressions. Some basic stuff you should know before you begin are the basic operations, how to add integers, and how to subtract integers. So make sure you know these things, and then let's get started. So first of all, what are algebraic expressions? First of all, expressions. An expression is a mathematical sentence. And it does not have an equal sign. Be very careful. A lot of people have heard the word equation, and they think automatically expressions and equations are the same thing. But guess what? They're not. Expressions do not have an equal sign at all. So what is an algebraic expression? An algebraic expression is just like an expression with a variable. So it doesn't have just numbers like standard numerical expressions, but it includes a variable. That's what makes it algebraic. Think about it. In algebra, you have variables. And terms. A term is an item in an expression separated by addition or subtraction. A lot of teachers try to go on and on about different technicalities and different ways to say it, but I honestly think saying that it's separated by addition or subtraction is probably the most straightforward, easiest way to see how many terms there are in an expression. Now, there are four types of algebraic expressions. The first is a monomial. A monomial is an expression with one term. And the reason why I highlighted the part that says mono is actually a prefix that means one. So a monomial is an expression with one term. For example, 3x. There's nothing here that's separated by addition or subtraction. Therefore, there's only one term, 3x. Another example, negative 7x squared. Again, even though there's a negative there, we're not adding or subtracting anything. So it's still one term. It is still a monomial. The next one, negative 23, a to the fourth, b to the fifth. It looks like it's a lot because you have a number, you have negative 23, you have one variable here and another variable here, but it's still not separated by addition or subtraction. Therefore, there's still only one term. Same thing here, 8wx to the fourth times y. Again, there's nothing separated by addition or subtraction. So all of that, no matter how long it is, it's still only one term. The second is a binomial. A binomial is an expression with two terms. The prefix bi means two. So it's an expression with two terms. For example, we have 3x plus 2. Now, here we have things separated by addition or subtraction. Here it's addition. So our first term is 3x, and our second term is plus 2. Okay, so it's a binomial. Here, negative 7cd minus x. We have two terms. The first is negative 7cd, and the second is minus x, or negative x. Now, you're going to hear me say a lot, negative x, or negative 7, minus 7. Keep in mind, algebraically, negative and minus mean the same thing. So they're going to be interchangeable. So we have one term here, negative 7cd, and negative x. Those are our two terms. Here, our first term is w to the fourth y. Our second term is 12. Here, our first term, we have two very long terms here. What's the first? Well, where are we separating by addition or subtraction? Well, we're separating by addition, okay? And that addition sign separates the first term here, negative 8q squared rs, and our second term, which is plus or positive 3ef to the fifth g. Now, don't get intimidated by the fact that there's a lot of variables here. The third one is a trinomial. And a trinomial is an expression with three terms. Again, it's pretty straightforward. That prefix tri means three, the same thing as you would hear in the word triangle. A triangle means that it's a shape with three sides. A tripod, if you have a tripod for a camera, is actually a stand that has three legs. Tri always means three. For example, we have 3x minus 8y plus 2. Now, remember, it's a term is separated by addition or subtraction. Here, we have minus 8y, okay? That separates these two. So my first term is 3x, and my second term is minus 8y or negative 8y, and my third term here is plus 2 or positive 2. Here, my three terms are x squared minus 10x plus 8. All three of those are terms. How about in this example? There's a lot here, okay? We have negative 9ab squared plus 10 minus 8b to the third. So, what do you think? Well, where are we separating by addition or subtraction? Well, our first separation by addition is here. So our first term is going to be negative 9ab squared. So where else are we separating? Well, we're separating by subtraction here. So that separates this. So that's going to be positive plus 10. That's my second term. And my third term is right here, negative 8b to the third. How about this one? Take a second, think about it. Remember, we're separating by addition or subtraction. So we're going to separate 8g to the third h plus 3f minus 17f squared. So we're separating this term and this term here by addition. So our first term is 10g to the third h, our second term is plus 3f, and our third term is minus 17f squared, or negative 17f squared. We also have polynomial. Now, poly is basically just an expression with more than one term. Binomials and trinomials are types of polynomials. It's important that you keep that in mind. Binomials and trinomials are polynomials. And the reason why is because this word poly, the word poly means many. Okay, so polynomial really just means an expression with many terms. So let's take a look. We have 3x plus 2. This is 3x, and that's positive 2. These are my two terms. The first term is 3x. The second term is positive 2. And because it has two terms, it is a binomial. And because it is a binomial, it is still technically also a polynomial. In this example here, 3x minus 8y plus 2. Well, how many terms do I have? I have 3. I've got 3x, negative 8y, and positive 2. Okay, there's three terms there, therefore it is a trinomial. And since it's a trinomial, it is technically also a polynomial. So keep in mind, that's very important. A lot of people think that when you say binomial or trinomial or polynomial, that they're separate things. Granted, a binomial and a trinomial are different, but a polynomial is more than one. So binomials and trinomials are still polynomials. Here we have 3xy. Now let's think about that. Is that a monomial, a binomial, a trinomial, a polynomial? Well, it's a monomial. It is not a polynomial because it only has one term. Remember, we said that a polynomial is an expression with many terms, and those terms will be separated by addition or subtraction. Since there's nothing there separated by addition or subtraction, it is only a monomial. Okay, so what kind of expression is this? How many terms are there? Remember, to determine the number of terms, we have to see how many things are separated by addition or subtraction. Well, these two terms are separated by addition, these two are separated by subtraction, and these two are separated by addition. So I've got my first term right here, which is 4w. Then I'm adding this, so it's positive 3x, or plus 3x is my second term. I'm subtracting this, so negative 8y or minus 8y is my third term, and positive 2 or plus 2 is my fourth term. So I have four terms, therefore this is a polynomial. So here's your pause and practice. Just pause and practice. When you're done, unpause the video. After a 3, 2, 1 countdown, your answers will be displayed. Go. Okay, so let's go over these answers. Number 1, the answer is monomial. Number 2 is a trinomial. 3 is a binomial. 4 is a polynomial, 5 is a binomial, 6 is a monomial, and 7 is a polynomial. Reflection. A mathematical sentence that does not have an equal sign is called an expression. Remember, there's a huge difference between an expression and an equation. Expressions do not have an equal sign. An equation does. An expression with a variable is called an algebraic expression. Remember, algebra involves variables. Therefore, if you have an expression with a variable, it's called an algebraic expression. Each item in an expression that is separated by addition or subtraction is called a term. An algebraic expression with only one term is a monomial. An algebraic expression with two terms is a binomial. An algebraic expression with three terms is a trinomial. And an algebraic expression with more than one term is a polynomial. And remember what we said before, binomials and trinomials are types of polynomials, because a polynomial has more than one term. A binomial has more than one term. A trinomial has more than one term. Therefore, they are both polynomials. And thanks for using Mr. Ace Math. Don't just pass math, ace it.